twice now the Green Party has had ministers in government and then defied political gravity by coming out of an election stronger than before. Co-leader James Shaw is with us this morning. Kia ora, congratulations on your result last night.
Thank you, Jack.
I'm asking everyone this, how many hours sleep, dare I ask?
Oh, it was at least four.
Oh, that's all you need.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's positively Winston Peters-esque, I believe. What do you make of the result last night?
Well, I mean, obviously, we're sad to be out of government, you know. We're really proud of the work that we've done over the last 6 years and would have liked to have been able to continue that for the next three. But we had a banger of a night, you know. We, like you said, we had a historic result in a number of ways, returning stronger at the end of a term of government, the only party, support party, to have done that. Chloe held Auckland Central. It's the only time we've ever held a seat for two elections. She won it against the red wave, kept it against the blue wave. We've turned Wellington green. You know, we've got, looks like, two MPs there, as well as a green mayor. So, it's a fantastic result. And we've got, at the moment, as many green MPs as we've ever had before, right? Mm. So we're back at our high water mark of 14 MPs. So it's a good result.
You said you are disappointed to be out of government. I'll just get this out of the way.
Yeah.
Because there is, of course, one two-party combination outside of a grand coalition with Labor and National that would comfortably command a majority, regardless of the result in the Port Waikato by-election. Would you consider having any conversations with the National Party?
Well, the Christopher Luxon said last week categorically he wasn't interested in working with us, so he hasn't called us.
And you don't expect him to?
No, I don't expect him to.
If he did, would you be interested in having those conversations?
Well, I'll just say, as I said to you last time, Jack, it would be rude not to pick up the phone, but ultimately that's up to the incoming Prime Minister, and I cannot imagine why he would try and work with a party that is as philosophically different from his party, where he's got someone in the ACT party who's much more philosophically the same. And the thing that gets me about that question, nobody ever goes to the ACT party and says, why wouldn't you work with the Labor Party? Mm. Right? No one ever says, you know, for the sake of the country, you know, a good dose of libertarian...
The ACT party doesn't build itself around the central concern that is an existential crisis, right? They don't say our primary concern is the existential crisis of climate change, and thus if a crisis is that critical, if we need to act that quickly, we'll do anything.
Yeah, look, I get that. But also, by the same token, every party should be treating climate change as the existential crisis that it is. Mm. Like, it should not be ghettoised in the Green Party or on the left. Mm. You know, this is something that we all face, right? And I think every party needs to be credible on it.
Talk to us about Wellington. Pretty remarkable to consider. Not only Wellington Central, Tamitha Paul,
yep,
becoming a new MP. Rongotai, Julianne Genta, comfortably ahead at the moment.
Yep.
Well, it's close, but yeah, she's probably set to hold that.
Oh, yeah, understanding is Fleur did ring her to concede.
So
I think they probably got to the point.
Yeah. And add to that, of course, Tory Whānau.
Yes.
So what does that say about the state of politics in Wellington and the support for the party in Wellington?
Well, it says that in Wellington, you've got a city that, you know, strongly believes in things like public transport rather than roads. So good luck to Simeon Brown, you know, trying to drill all his tunnels in Mount Victoria against opposition from the local MPs and from the council. You've got a population that, you know, is kind of very concerned around climate change, who is very motivated to make sure that we take everyone with us, that we don't leave anyone behind. So, you know, I think we've always had very, very strong Green support, and now we've converted that into local representation, which I'm delighted about.
What do you make of Labor's result last night?
Well, it was obviously a shellacking, right? I mean, it was a terrible result for them. And, you know, they lost some really, really good people. They'll be feeling quite shattered, I would imagine.
What do you put it down to?
Look, I think, and that's up to them, you know. I think they've got to go back and kind of analyse their campaign and some of the kind of strategic things. I mean, frankly, even if they'd made every strategic decision right, and if they'd had perfect execution, they would still be pushing the proverbial uphill with the rake because we are in a situation where, you know, and people may understand that the reasons are to do with the Ukraine war or to do with, COVID supply chains being all messed up or whatever. It doesn't matter. when, you know, your block of cheese is $13 a kilo and you've got to pay, you know, you're spending more than 50% of your income on rents and, you know, that kind of stuff. And your mortgages, you know, people are refixing at 8% when they bought it too. All of that, you know, the reasons for that don't matter. People are just in this situation that they are in. And so I think any incumbent party, if it had been the National Party, they would have, you know, faced an uphill battle as well.
How are you going to be effective in opposition?
The way that we always have been, Jack. We've got a big new team. I've got half the MPs coming in on Monday will be new. Mm. First time we've had that situation since 2011. And that gives us a lot more spread. It means that we'll be able to be on every select committee. It means that we'll be able to ask more questions in the House. It means that we'll have, frankly, more staff resource to help us with kind of research and analysis and things like that. And people will be really fired up and ready to go.
Have you had any thoughts as to your personal future?
I haven't, Jack. I mean, at one level you think about it all the time, but, you know, I said to you before the election that I was just putting all in on winning.
Yeah, you've had 8 hours to consider it now, James. It's all the time in the world, isn't
barely,
it?
Barely, and I have to say I wasn't doing a lot of thinking for some of that, so I was doing quite a lot of drinking. But no, I just, you know, haven't really had a chance to kind of think all of that through.
Do you reckon that once the specials are in, the Greens can expect another seat?
I don't know. I'd obviously like one. Yeah. But, you know, we just ticked over from 13 to 14 MPs quite late last night. That means it's quite a big hurdle to get to the 15th.
Yeah.
But the number of specials, I understand, was bigger than it's been before.
567,000.
It's huge.
20%, that's massive.
Huge numbers. Yeah. Huge numbers. And they, you know, a lot of those will be students voting from out of town. You know, you've got the international votes. Both of those kind of tend to favour the Greens historically. So you never know. I'd love to get Kahurangi Carter in from Christchurch. She'd be a fantastic MP. She'll come up to Wellington to do induction just in case. But I've been in her position before. I was number 15 on the list back in 2011 when we got 14 MPs in then too. So I know the experience that she'll be going through.
Well, congratulations on the result last night. Thank you very much for getting up early after a big night. We really appreciate it.
You're welcome.